One plot we've been following in Ruby for a while now is what exactly this strange Grimm, known as the Hound, actually is. As a lot of people noticed, it wasn't like the other Grimm in that it seemed to have some sentience beyond simply wanting to kill any human in its path. For many fans, a theory popped up that it could actually be Summer Rose, Ruby's mother. In episode 8, however, we discovered that it was in fact a human, but that it was not Summer Rose herself, which brings us back to a question fans have been asking since the show's inception. What exactly happened to Summer Rose? My name's Deep Cut, welcome to Cartoon Universe, and subscribe for 7 years of good luck. Now for today's theory, I'll be referencing a Reddit post by Toshiro46 quite a bit. In the post, they discuss the theory that Summer was the Hound, and while that is invalidated by the recent reveal that it was this other schmuck, it still has a lot of relevant information to the idea that this could happen to Summer at a later point. At first glance, there might not have been anything special about the person who became the Hound, but on closer inspection, we see that he is a Faunus who seems to have fox ears, probably a clever allusion to Fox and the Hound. However, the part of him that I will be focusing on for this video is his one remaining eye, which just happens to be silver, as you can clearly see by the small flecks at the bottom of his eyes, which only happens to silver eyes in this show. Silver-eyed people are very rare in the world of Ruby, and Salem has a history of hunting them down, so the fact that she used a silver-eyed Faunus for this hybrid seems to be very intentional on her part, and this lays the groundwork down for Summer to not just be a Grimm herself somewhere down the road, but perhaps something even worse. As we all know about the Grimm, they were created by the God of Darkness, and have a hatred for humans that drives their existence to kill as many humans as possible. It is uncertain if their goal is to just cause as much suffering as they can, or if their desire in the back of their minds is to eventually rid the entire world of them, which would explain why they have somewhat evolved over time to be more patient and to focus on finding weaknesses in human defenses instead of attacking them blindly on sight, as we see in a lot of cases. According to the fairy tale, The Two Brothers, the Grimm were created by the God of Darkness in order to destroy the creations of the God of Light. The two eventually ended their infighting and worked together to create humans. At this point, the God of Darkness began to favor humans over the Grimm, and the Grimm began attacking humans specifically because of that, indicating that they do have some sense of emotion, even if it's all just some universal hive mind, and it explains why they don't attack the other animals around and focus only on the humans despite existing before them. In many ways, the Grimm are the antithesis of humanity, entirely incompatible, so much so that even when merged, a human's aura can't be used to protect or enhance their Grimm aspects, which raises the question of how such a thing happened to begin with. Well, it all comes back to Salem, who in many ways is the purest version of a human meeting a Grimm. Salem was of course once a normal human, but she was cursed with immortality for turning the gods against one another. In an attempt to truly end her life, she ventured into the Land of Darkness, where she submerged herself in a pool of Grimm essence. This backfired as, again, she is immortal, and since it was impossible for the Grimm to simply end her existence, it instead became a part of her. As far as we know, this would make Salem the first and only Grimm hybrid up to this point. When it comes to the Hound, Salem notes that he is an experiment, one that you would believe is inspired by her own existence. The Hound and Salem are not the only hybrids we see, however. Cinder is a character that's been around from the very beginning, but as she developed, it appeared that she has some power over Grimm similar to Salem, though to an extremely lesser degree, and perhaps only with Salem's own blessing as the Grimm follow her. Later on, of course, Ruby's silver eyes mess Cinder up real bad, and she loses her arm, which is then replaced with a Grimm arm. As of now, silver eyes are only seen to be harmful to the Grimm, with the exception of Cinder, as we just noted. This would indicate that Cinder was already fusing with the Grimm before her arm was replaced. What Reddit user Toshiro46 posits is that the only way to create a human-Grimm hybrid is with the help of magic, which is something essentially mythological to the characters in the show. While we see magic dust, auras that hear people, semblances that give powers, and human-animal hybrids with seemingly magical abilities, all of these are considered to be part of the natural development of humans within the show, practically science as opposed to magic. Instead, magic refers to other gifts, generally believed to come from the gods, that were not given to the second wave of humans that came after the first extinction brought upon by Salem. This is why Salem and Ozpin both have magic, but other humans do not. Other humans, with the exception of people with silver eyes. While they are few and far between, this magic is believed to come from the God of Light, as he himself also has silver eyes when he takes his dragon form. While Cinder was not born with magic herself, the power of the Maidens comes from magic that Ozpin had, and after using a Grimm to transfer the Fall Maiden's power to herself, Cinder is then able to merge with the beetle used to steal that power shortly afterward. This would explain why Salem would risk using silvered-eyed humans, particularly Summer Rose, for her human-Grimm hybrids, specifically because they are the only humans who are known to have natural magic within them, despite the threat they pose to her. So, why hasn't Summer appeared as one yet? Why experiment with this other man before Summer? Well, the simplest way to put it is that the Grimm are the antithesis of humanity, to our souls, to concepts that exist philosophically alongside it, such as hope. Ruby herself captures that perfectly. She is never one to give up hope. She never stops believing that they can't handle what is to come, no matter how big their problems are or how insignificant she may feel. In Toshiro46's post, they explain that seeing Summer become corrupted and turn to a Grimm would give Ruby the chance to succeed where her mother had failed, playing into an ongoing trend of characters trying to become better than their parents, or at least to improve upon their failings. However, the fact that she has not been revealed to be the Hound indicates that they may have a different plan for her. Instead, I believe that part of the reason Salem wants Ruby to be taken alive, aside from the fact that she has silver eyes so could be further use in her experiments, could be to help break Summer down. If Summer has a strong resolve, like Ruby, she may have been resisting being overcome by the Grimm for quite some time now, but seeing Ruby captured, perhaps tortured, or God knows what else, might make her lose what sense of hope she had left and become a Grimm, though this is just one of many possibilities. Finally, before I go, I want to point out that Salem may not exactly be the first hybrid we've seen, or at least the first to appear in this universe. When the gang manages to kill the Hound, the Grimm parts fade away just like with any other Grimm. While we don't know the fate of the Faunus, it would seem that he is dead as well. More interestingly, the Grimm leaves behind a skeletal arm, something no Grimm has done before, implying it has something to do with it being a Grimm-human hybrid. When Salem first ventured into the Land of Darkness, it was said that humans do not go there because they know of its dangers, and we see a human skeleton with a blade in it. It wouldn't really make sense for humans to be afraid to go to the Land of Darkness because of other humans, and Grimm don't wield weapons like this. And so I think there is a very slim possibility that this human had merged with a Grimm in some way, perhaps as an experiment from the God of Darkness himself, and someone else had to kill it, leaving behind only a skeleton. That being said, the skeleton seems fully human, and the one left behind by the Grimm-Faunus hybrid seems to match the body of the Grimm, not the Faunus, so this is likely just wishful thinking on my part. But this is all speculation. Do you think Toshiro and myself are onto something here, and if not, what's your favorite theory about what happened to Summer? Let me know in a comment down below, and I'll see you next time.